gesetzt hat.
"90% of all information that goes into your brain is visual. And therefore, it's very important what we all are talking about, what we are covering. You need to know your customer journey. Depending on the area where you first get in touch with your customer, when he sees the product, you need to show great content. 70% of marketing strategy experts say you need to have great visuals in order to convince a prospect to a customer. What we see here is a content funnel. It's just one example. It doesn't include all the assets, but it shows the complexity. We have more than 50 different models with millions of configurations, updates, at least two major ones a year, minor ones on top, always in between. We have different variations up to the markets. And in the content funnel, the customer is facing different kinds of contents. It's static images, active images, it's pre-produced movies, and of course, interactive stuff. And the interactive stuff we showed you last year, we solved for the retail. And with this, we also try to dive deeper into this. So let's assume you solved this topic, but you need to think beyond, you need to go further. What you are going to need, you need more content for more channels, and therefore you need to be more flexible. And the future is going to be different than today. You're going to have AI-driven recommendations. You want to show personalized, location-based, and device-specific content. And the major factor for this is time to market. And you can't run a proper offline production, have the briefing, brief your agency, get the stuff back, do the QA, take care about the distribution. You need to want to have it there instantly, so as instant as possible. And therefore, in our mind, the Unreal Engine 4 could be an option. But before we talk about the future, and you take care about the future, you need to do your homework. So what we showed you last year was the claim, own the process, own the data, enable the experience, you maybe remember. So these are some of the results what we did. And the total model conversions for 3 model years for the entire global lifecycle came down from 160 to 50. And I'm very proud about the team that we achieved this. The major indicator was the standardization, which enabled the automation. This means per model conversion, instead of 5 days, 0.5 days. In a total, less than 100 days instead of 1,000 days. And more information in details about the tech stuff is going to tell you Dominic.
Thank you, Thomas. So I will tell you some technical stuff we did since last build. So what did we do since last build? We did no major visual improvements, and we also did no fancy features. What? But we did actually a lot of things. A few I can tell. Of course, we have a live system. This means we have to do life cycle. We did a bunch of bug fixes, refactoring, architectural changes. Life cycle for 211 cars, 3 model years are available right now, which is 57 cars in total. We improved the model pipeline, it's more automated at supporting the link standard. We created the first Fascinator content, offline content for the website. We developed a cloud streaming system. We restructured our whole Perfo server. We created a complete new CI/CD pipeline. We developed an install update system. And of course, a lot of tools which are just handy in our daily lives. And of course, a lot more what I cannot tell you right now, but maybe next build. I will talk about in detail about cloud streaming and the install update system. So first, cloud streaming. The general idea is to have the application run in the cloud. So the client is device independent. He can have any device. There's very minimal requirements on the device. And he just gets the same quality like with the local workstation hardware at the dealerships. This is the major benefit that you are device independent and can scale much more. And there are other benefits. I just clicked through. I'm running out of time. We talked to Epic when we started our development 1 year ago. And actually, they told us, hey, guys, we already developed something or in development with something. And it's called Pixel Streaming. It wasn't public back then. And we met with the dev team from Epic who did Pixel Streaming. And we were able to talk to them and give them our requirements. And Pixel Streaming has been a very, very smooth experience for us the first time we got it. It was more or less plug and play. It was only one bug, and it was fixed immediately. So some facts about Pixel Streaming. It comes with the engine. It's a plugin you have to enable. It uses WebRTC. It streams via H264 video encoding. It's super easy to set up. It just works as soon as you have the necessary bandwidth and some browser requirements, but any up-to-date browser can handle that. And we need 2 to 5 Mbits for an HD stream in high quality, so no major compression artifacts. Also, just to finish that up, in the exhibition hall, you can experience the Pixel Streaming live. So we have a bunch of iPads. It's just the website. You can see there. You can take the iPad and try it out yourself. So Pixel Streaming upcoming feature. Till now, we are still collaborating with Epic and giving their our requirements what we think should be beneficial for Pixel Streaming. And three of the things which are upcoming soon and available soon is FreeStream. This means you can pause the stream to freeze the image to a certain quality, and if the bandwidth of the user gets down, he still has this stream, this image in his cache. So you always have high quality then. The compression was improved as well, so it's much more reliable and much more high quality. And it got a little bit easier because the WebRTC proxy component threw out completely. Next topic, install update system. So the basic idea here is to have a flexible update system which has small data update size. Our application has 40 gigabytes of disk space. And the dealerships can have quite low bandwidth, so we don't want to download the 40 gigabytes of application all the time or big chunks of it, so we want to have the lowest possible update size. And most of the time, there's only a small fix, like a material was wrong and this got fixed, no need to download the whole car, it's just that one material. We evaluated different systems in the market and again talked to Epic, and they told us there is build patch services already for a long time. It comes with the engine. So compared to other features in the engines, there's really zero documentation. Other stuff is documented very well, but this not. This is because it's used internally by Epic in the Epic Games Launcher. So we got told we are the second client who ever asked for it. So that means something. There's not the need of the documentation right now. and we believe it's actually a piece of black magic. And this is how it looks like. At least it's black. The magic you have to find yourself. So to generate an update, it's there's a tool called build patch services. It's a BAT file you can, or an .exe file. You can launch with some parameters, and this will create you a complete installation repository. Means you get a manifest which describes your installation or your composition, and you get a chunk folder. These are cryptic files, and only with a manifest you can recombine the chunks to an installation. And to install this, you need to write your own installer. But this is very quickly been done. It takes 1 or 2 days, and you have your own install system to manage all of this. So big shout out to Leek. He helped us a lot. He's from Epic and working on the system. The system itself, Buildpatch Services, compensates various scenarios very, very well. It's super efficient and flexible. So if you make only small changes, it's only very small delta update size. If you rename a file even, it's 0 kilobyte of update size, so it's amazing. And even engine updates, which is of course important for us because we have a live system and we want to have all the new features. We do engine updates regularly, and so we need to cover that. And if you do an engine update, every file changes. So, but we've seen update sizes from 70 to 100 megabytes if you change the engine. So quite nice. Yeah, we are very, very happy with Buildpatch Services. It's a great tool. Yeah, and we are hiring. So Unreal developer and engine developers, of course, cloud engineers, product owners, scrum masters, full stack developers, Java developers, and much more. So if you're interesting in the stuff we do, just get in touch with us. We are an amazing team, and yeah. Thank you.